I'm walking south on East 55th Street on the near east side of downtown Cleveland, Ohio. East 55th Street is an important street in my family's history, in the history of the city of Cleveland, and in the history of the United States, and in the history of the cross-pollination of the rock and roll universe. My father was born on this street, just six blocks north on the other side of the street. Five blocks north of that, he grew up, and he worked with my uncle over at League Park, where Babe Ruth hit his 500th home run. Just another block south of here is where the old East Tech High School stood, where Jesse Owens ran high school track and then on to Ohio State. And from there, he went to the 1936 Olympics, where he won four gold medals and embarrassed Adolf Hitler. But here at the corner of Central Avenue, which is directly in front of me, and 55th Street, stood the Majestic Hotel. This hotel was here for the first half of the 20th century. In the hotel was the Rose Room, where a lot of black performers came to perform and came to stay because they weren't allowed to live or stay or perform in the hotels in downtown Cleveland. In the Rose Room, two young men from Birmingham, Alabama came here, Paul Williams and Eddie Kendricks. After they left Cleveland, Ohio, they went to Detroit, where they became very famous as lead singers of the Temptations. Just a few feet up behind this location here at the corner of Central Avenue and East 55th Street, I have a friend waiting for me. He's part of that history and he knows that history well. This is Paul Williams Jr. Paul Williams Jr. is the sixth child, the baby of the family, right, of Paul Williams Sr.
Absolutely right.
Paul, tell us who your father was.
My father was actually an original member of the Temptations, and it all began here.
It all began here.
He left home in Birmingham. It's the first place he moved to.
And who did he leave home with?
Eddie Kendricks. He left home with Eddie Kendricks, and it all started here.
Where did they live when they were here in Cleveland, during their short time here in Cleveland?
Halfway apartment complex.
Yeah.
It's right down the street, right up the road.
Just south of here, it's just the other side of where the old East Tech High School had been. And in this site behind us where the Goodwill building now stands.
My understanding, it used to be a hotel.
The hotel, the Majestic Hotel.
Where my father used to work, him and Eddie.
Your father, Eddie was a dishwasher.
My father was a bellhop.
A bellhop. And at night, what would they do at night?
Go singing.
They'd sing. They'd sing every
night. All night long. I hear they just sing until they could just fall asleep.
They sing until they couldn't stay up any longer. They fell asleep. The next morning, they'd get up and they'd repeat the process.
All over again.
Because they wanted to make it in the music business.
And they made it.
They finally did make it, but not without a couple of bumps and twists and turns. There was a lady here whose name was Caldonia Young. She was a contortionist, right, and what they call a shake dancer. And she convinced your father to stay with the business and not to give up, not to go back to Birmingham, and she took them to what city?
Detroit, Michigan.
Detroit, Michigan, where they met...
Detroit.
Where they met...
Otis Williams from the distance, and Barry Gordy, and the story tells itself.
It all became part of our history, of the great music that we know as Motown and as the Temptations. Now tell me about some of the songs. You're a singer now.
That's right. I sing right now with Dennis Edwards, Temptation Repeat.
You sing with Dennis. Now Dennis became the lead singer of the Temps when David Ruffin left.
In 1968.
And he sang with your father.
He sure did.
What are some of the songs that you remember that your father sang lead on with the Temptations?
Wow, songs like I Want a Love I Could See, Don't Look Back.
I Want a Love I Can See, that was the first song that Smokey wrote for the Temps.
You're absolutely right. That was on Meet the Temptations album.
And your father sang lead on that.
That's right. Check Yourself.
Check Yourself. Now that was before Smokey took over. That was before they even got on the Motown label.
A lot of people don't realize that my father was an original Temptation, and he also was the lead singer of Temptations.
What songs? From day one. What songs did your father sing?
Songs like "No More Water in the Well," "Check Yourself," "Who You Gonna Run To," It's various songs.
And of course, I Want a Love I Can See.
I Want a Love I Can See.
Now that was the very first song that Smokey wrote and produced for the Temptations. Your father also sang lead in 1968. David sang lead on I Wish It Would Rain. Then Eddie sang lead on one more song, and then Paul sang lead on the last song before Dennis took over. See her, I'm gonna give her all the love I got. That's one of my favorite songs by the Temps, and really one of my favorite Motown songs. Then Dennis took over. Now you sing Don't Look Back.
Don't Look Back.
That was one of your father's songs.
Surely was.
Okay. What other songs do you remember your father singing with the Temps?
For Once in My Life.
For Once in My Life.
For Once in My Life. That's one of my all-time favorites of my father. For Once in My Life.
Now, I saw him sing that song at the Versailles Motor in June, I think it was June 12th, 1967. I just graduated the week before. And my buddy said, we got a ticket for you. We sat in the front row, and after they sang that, they sang Hello, Young Lovers, and they shook all of our hands. Now, for an 18-year-old kid, you get to meet the Temps. For that time in my life, that was a thrill. And I saw them again November 11th of 67 when I was a freshman at Ohio University. Your father and the other Temps were in the locker room, and a buddy of mine and I, we snuck into the locker room. That was their dressing room. We talked to them. We walked out to their car with them and with the band, and there was a limousine that was behind your father got into the limousine with three other Temps. David Ruffin got into his own limousine behind that one.
Oh, David was David.
Yes, he was. He had his name put on the side with his specs. And we talked to your father, we talked to Melvin, talked to Eddie, we talked to Paul, and the four of them, we said goodbye, and then David said, put his window down. He wanted us to come over and talk to him. He didn't want to talk to us, but he wanted us to talk to him. And we asked him why he had his own car, his own limousine. He didn't want to talk about it. But he just wanted us to tell him what a great show it was, and it was, of course. And I think that might have been the last show I've seen. I know it was, that with David leading the Temps.
While the Temps have given us great music, four of them have passed away. Paul was the first to die at the age of 34 on August 17, 1973, through a sudden and tragic event. David died on June 1st, 1991, after having toured London with Eddie and Dennis. They were getting paid cash every week throughout the spring of 1991, but the promoter didn't have the cash to pay them for the final week. Everyone wanted to return to the United States, but David suggested that he stay behind with his brother Jimmy, who lived in London, until the cash arrived. He carried this large amount of cash with him in a briefcase. He took a plane from London directly to Philadelphia. From there, he got into a limousine and went to a crack house. He bought enough crack that he overdosed. The limousine driver then took him with his empty briefcase and dropped him off in front of an emergency room at a Philadelphia hospital, where he died. The following year, Eddie Kendricks lost his life to lung cancer on October 5, 1992. Eddie and Dennis had toured Japan with Damon Harris. Damon replaced Eddie in the Temptations. Eddie only had one lung at this time, and he needed Damon Harris to support him on stage. This photo was taken on July 18, 1992, the day after the last concert. July 17th was Damon Harris's birthday. A little more than halfway through the concert, Eddie approached Damon and bumped him with his shoulder and said, "Close the show." Damon was puzzled. Eddie did it again. He bumped him and said, "I said, close the show." This was Eddie's last concert. Eddie, who was acting as business manager for the group, took all of the money and prepaid his funeral. He knew he was dying, and he didn't want to die like David, who was unable to pay for his own funeral. The final Temptation to have passed away was Melvin Franklin. In 1978, Melvin was the victim of a carjacking. During the carjacking, he was shot 5 times, but the assailant recognized him and said, "I'm going to let you live." His health deteriorated, and in February of 1995, he sunk into a coma, and after 6 days of unconsciousness, he died on February 23, 1995. And the band played on.